A lot of times men feel that they don't have a reason to go to the doctor. And I don't know if it's a syndrome. I don't know if it's just pride. We're guys, we're not gonna go to the doctor. My brother made that same mistake. It was a fatal mistake. He didn't go. My brother was just full of life. Two kids, a wife, doing very well. Top of his game. And he didn't wake up. Then one day he didn't wake up. Definitely, if we could go back, yeah, he'd have his sleep study done.
Sleep apnea is common. It affects up to 1 in 4 men, up to 1 in 10 women. And it has a lot of very serious effects. Untreated severe sleep apnea is very dangerous for the heart. It can triple your chances of having a heart attack. It can increase your chances of having atrial fibrillation by twofold. A lot of patients with high blood pressure have it because of untreated sleep apnea. And then it can raise your chances of having really the terminal condition of congestive heart failure by about 58%. We're talking about the end of the cardiac lifespan being accelerated because of untreated, unrecognized, undiagnosed sleep apnea.
I had no idea that sleep apnea had anything to do with cardiac issues. I thought it was snoring. I thought it was just disruptive sleep patterns. I've woken up and had my wife down the hall in the guest room, and you know, you're snoring so loud, you're waking up the whole house. Oh, it's just snoring, it's no big deal. I'll get one of those little devices you put in your mouth and it'll resolve that. I'm glad I didn't do that, because that would not have addressed my cardiac issue.
Sleep apnea is a silent killer. A lot of what happens during sleep apnea occurs while you're asleep. When we're asleep, all of our muscles relax, which is on purpose so we don't act out our dreams and injure ourselves or people around us. But in people with sleep apnea, the throat muscles relax so much that they collapse on themselves. In response, your body has to react to it with a very important fight or flight type mechanism that saves your life and makes you breathe, but is also extremely stressful for the heart. It interrupts the resting cycle. Again, this all happens while you're asleep, so typically patients don't realize this is happening. A bed partner might say, oh, this person snores, or I've seen them stop breathing, but the actual person themselves, usually they don't realize what's going on. And in fact, if you ask a person before they do a sleep study if they think they're going to test positive or negative, among those who tested positive, who have sleep apnea, 85% of them will tell you, I don't think I'm going to test positive. I'm only doing this because my doctor tells me to.
When I first heard or considered the sleep study after Dr. Wang's recommendation, of course, like anyone else, I'm thinking, great, I'm going to the hospital, I've got to check in overnight, it's going to feel strange, it's going to feel awkward. It looked just like a little hotel room. The staff walked me through all the paperwork, super simple. It didn't feel very clinical or institutional at all. Setting me up, they took great care to put all the leads, the EEG and the EKG on me. And believe it or not, I was asleep within an hour and a half.
A lot of people are afraid of sleep studies because they think they may not be able to get to sleep or that the environment may be too harsh. Typically, we do our sleep studies in the hospital and the equipment is actually very quiet. And so we do everything we can to make the patient a lot more comfortable. But with these kinds of techniques, we're able to identify sleep apnea very easily with a very high level of accuracy. Find out what could possibly threaten your future, giving us a chance to fix it before it causes problems.
It's not just my high blood pressure that's been improved. It's been my memory, my ability to concentrate. And so you just wake up with more energy. You wake up ready to go. It's like it's like the fog has been lifted. And all the folks I know that have their CPAP that use it regularly have the same story to tell of all the benefits, the improvements in their life.
If your doctor asks you to do a sleep study, I'd strongly recommend that you do it. It's a very serious matter and it could be one of the most important tests that you can take.
It can happen to anyone. It's not just the few folks, and I wouldn't go by height, weight. Oh, it can never happen to the folks that, you know, I go to the gym regularly. Hey, it's just, you know, it's no big deal. Don't make that mistake. Go get it checked out.